Can't see you. Okay, so we're going to come down onto the mat. Thank you very much for joining me, everyone. We're going to start in child's pose. Feet together, knees go wide apart. Extend your arms towards the top of the mat, arms long and straight, and fingers spread, palms facing down. Forehead rests onto a block or onto the mat or onto a towel. If you need to yawn, then get that little yawn out. But close your eyes and start to breathe. Breathe in through the nose. Let's breathe out through the nose. So we're going to come into our Ujjayi breath. As you breathe out, you energetically send your hips down towards your heels. As you breathe in, you expand the sides of your ribcage. Again, as you exhale, you send your hips down, you draw your belly inwards. Take another deep inhale. As you exhale, come up into your tabletop position. So stack your joints, shoulders above the wrists, hips above the knees. Let's take in a few cat and cows now. So we'll breathe into our first cow by sending the belly down, tailbone up, chest forward, shoulders back. Exhale everything out by lifting through the spine, tucking tailbone, looking to belly. Nice deep inhale. Belly down, maybe bend those elbows if you need to. And then exhale everything out. Lift through the spine, tuck the tailbone, look to the belly. Let's take that long breath in. Big inhale. Filling up the lungs, and then exhale, emptying everything out, drawing the belly in, lifting through the spine, long neck. Big breath in. Exhale out. And again, deep inhale. Full exhale. Tabletop position as you breathe in. Okay, we're going to send that right arm towards the front of the mat. Left leg goes towards the back of the mat. Looking down at the ground. So we've got a long straight line going all the way from the back foot through the spine, all the way up to the fingertips. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, right elbow into the hip, knee into the nose. Inhale, stretch out. Exhale, elbow to hip, knee to nose. Lift through the spine. Breath in and stretch. Exhale, draw it in. Two more, inhale. Exhale out. Big breath in. Exhale out, this time hold. Good, so elbow goes into knee, elbow goes into hip, knee goes up into nose. So relax your neck. Relax your neck, allow the back of the neck to be long. Good, lifting that left knee up. You've got to use core muscles a little bit here. Take another inhale. As you exhale, stretch it out. Hold the stretch, breath in. Reach backwards as you breathe out. Take hold of the right ankle. Left ankle, foot is flexed. Fill up the chest, breath in. Now kick backwards and open to the side as you breathe out. So you want to lift your left knee up and away from the ground. So you'll feel this in the front of the thigh. Front of the left thigh, the left glute muscle should be firing up as well to lift that leg nice and high. And each time you breathe out, you'll kick backwards, open the chest to the side of the room. Deep inhale, full exhale. One more breath in and release as you breathe out. Good, left arm goes forwards, right leg reaches backwards, long straight line. Good, so we're stretching out, really stretching it out. Take a breath in. Elbow to hip, knee to nose as you breathe out. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, elbow to knee, knee to nose. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, draw it all in. Good, breath in and stretch. Exhale, draw it in. One more, inhale, stretch. Exhale, draw it in, this time hold. Good, so we're lifting through the spine. So we have a curve. We've got the long neck at the back of us, curve through the shoulder blades, through mid into lower spine. So we want to tuck that tailbone underneath. Elbow is really drawing in towards the hip as the knee draws in towards the nose. Good, another deep inhale. As you exhale, stretch it out. Hold the stretch, take a breath in. As you breathe out, reach backwards, take hold of the right ankle. Right foot is flexed. Try to go for the ankle rather than the foot. Gives you a little bit more to grip onto. Breath in. As you breathe out, kick backwards, lift that right knee up away from the ground. Good, inhale, expand the front of the chest. Exhale, roll the left shoulder backwards, opening more to the left side of the room. Deep inhale, full exhale. Again, breath in and release as you breathe out. Let's take one more set of cutting cows. Inhale, send the belly down, tailbone up, chest forward. Exhale, everything out. Lift through the spine, now tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Good, now walk your dog out. So just walk your dog out, pad your heels, pad your hands, bend your elbows, bend your knees. Good, move and breathe. Just gonna have a little rearrange here. Good, now work your way back into your neutral down dog position. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, step or float to the top of the mat. Halfway lift, forward fold. Inhale, rise and shine to the ceiling. Lift toes, knees and ribs as you reach up. As you breathe out, bring the palms together at the center of the chest. Close the eyes, take an inhale. Open the mouth as you exhale. We'll open our practice with three ohms. Breath in. Om. Have an awesome practice, everyone. Inhale, send those hands high. Exhale, bow forwards. Flat back breath in. Exhale, the hands down, step or float into high plank. Lower down to low plank with elbows tucked in. Up dog as you breathe in. Down dog as you breathe out. Take a deep inhale and a full exhale. Breath in. Breath out. Expand the sides of the ribs as you inhale. Draw the belly in as you exhale. Fill up the shoulder blades as you breathe in. Roll the shoulders out as you breathe out. Send the hips up, inhale. Heels and hands down as you exhale. Again, breath in. Breath out. Feet come together, deep inhale. Step or float to the top of the mat as you exhale. Halfway lift, forward fold, rise and shine to the ceiling, breath in, bow forwards, breath out, flat back, inhale, send the hands down, step or float into high plank, elbows in for low plank, you can have knees down if you need to, and then breathe into your up dog, exhale, downward facing dog, fill up, empty out, breath in, breath out. Expand the ribs as you inhale. Draw the belly in as you exhale. Fill up the shoulder blades as you breathe in. Relax the neck as you breathe out. Big inhale. Full exhale. One more breath in. Step, jump, or float to the top of the mat as you breathe out. Halfway lift. Forward fold. Rise and shine to ceiling, breath in. Bow forwards, breath out. Deep inhale. Hands down, step or float into high plank. Lower down to low plank. Up dog breath in. Down dog breath out. Fill up. Empty out. Okay, so now we're going to do a little bit of balancing in our down dogs. So we're going to do a few of these, actually. So we'll start off quite easy on the first one, okay? So the first one, what we're going to do is both hands remain on the ground. We inhale, we send that left leg about halfway up than what you would normally do if you were going into a three-legged, okay? So keep your right foot engaged, right leg engaged, left heel is pushing down. Okay, now what I want you to do is stay in that three-legged, or half a three-legged down dog, and now lift the left hand up off the ground, maybe 2 to 3 inches, okay? So nice and easy to start off with. You may feel like you need to put the hand down again, which is okay, you can do that, but then lift it back up. So you're using right hand, left foot to balance. Now keep holding. Hold and breathe. Don't hold the breath, just the pulse. Use your core muscles. So lock in the core muscles. Take a deep inhale. Send the left hand and right foot down as you exhale. Okay, let's go for the other side now. So lift that left leg up. So you can go about a foot off. You can go about halfway. We don't want to go too high. So keep it about halfway for now. As you breathe in, now lift that right hand up off the ground. So with that left leg about halfway up, you've got more control of your balance. You know, you can send that right arm out a little bit or bring it in. You can send the left leg out a little bit or bring it in. Good, now breathe. Keep pushing backwards through the chest. You may find that your hand is sort of slipping forwards. Just put the right hand down, push yourself back into your down dog. Take a deep inhale. Place the hand way down as you exhale. Nearly lost my balance there. Take a big breath in. Step or float to the top of the mat as you breathe out. Halfway lift. Forward fold. Inhale, rise and shine to the ceiling. Bow forwards, breath out. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, the hands down, step or float into high plank. Low plank, elbows tucked in. Up dog, breath in. Down dog, breath out. Okay, so now we're gonna go a little bit deeper into that balance. So again, you're gonna lift that right foot up off the ground. And you can go halfway or you can go a little bit higher this time. Okay, now with the left hand, so what I'll do is I'll turn around and show you. We've got our right leg up off the ground. Still pushing the chest backwards. Take the left hand and place it way onto the right hip. Good, so taking hold of the right hip, sending that chest backwards. So right hand, left foot is down on the mat. Whew, good. Doesn't matter if you lose balance. If you lose balance, you bounce back in again, okay? Come back into three-legged. Then send the right foot up, lift the left hand off, take it to the hip. Good, I'm gonna give you three more breaths. Good, pushing the chest backwards towards the thigh. Take another deep inhale. Place the hand and foot down as you exhale. Okay, so now the left leg is gonna go up. Send it up as high as you can go. Three-legged down dog. Good, take a breath in. And now send that right hand into the right hip. Good, breathe. So it's a lot easier when you just got to breathe, not breathe and talk at the same time. So if you are talking, okay, stop talking and just breathe. Just in case anyone's at home talking. Okay, now use the core muscles. Core muscles lock in really good. This is good for obliques. Okay, take a deep inhale. Send the chest back as you exhale. I didn't say put the foot down, did I? Send the chest back as you exhale. Take another breath in and release as you breathe out. Hands and foot goes down onto the mat. Deep inhale, step, jump, or float to the top of the mat as you exhale. Halfway lift, breath in, forward fold, breath out. Inhale, rise and shine, big stretch up. Bow forwards as you breathe out. Flat back, inhale. Send the hands down, step or float into high plank. Lower down to low plank. Up dog, breath in. Down dog, breath out. Okay, so we're gonna do one more of these down dog balancing. But this time, so you've got the choice actually. You can go for the easier one, which is right leg about a foot or halfway up, left arm comes off. The one we just done a moment ago, or you can lift the right leg up, bend at the knee, take the left hand, and then reach backwards for a bind, taking hold of the right ankle. Whee! Okay, I'm going to try this on the left side so you can actually see me doing this rather than just turning around. You'll reach backwards, take hold, and then open out. Good. Doesn't matter if you lose balance. Lose balance, you come back in again. There we go. Take a deep inhale. Whoa. Place that hand and foot down as you exhale. Okay, let's go for the other side now. So lift that left foot up off the ground. Okay, now lift the right hand up off the ground. Send it backwards. So you're going to bend the knee, kind of almost stacking the hips a little bit here, but you don't want to stack too much. Take hold. So we stay in that down dog formula. Then we push the chest backwards. It's a lot easier to do if you're not trying to talk at the same time. Good. How are we doing there, Mel? That's it, Laura. Yes. That's it. Bend the knee. Reach backwards. Good, Ursula. Nice. Corey. Oh, good fall out. Good bail out. I like it. Good. Liam's there. Perfect. Nice little bind. Okay. Take a deep inhale, everyone. Exhale. Send the hand and foot down to the mat. Take a breath in. Step or float to the top as you breathe out. Halfway lift. Forward fold. Inhale. Rise and shine to the ceiling. Exhale. Bow forwards. Flat back. Inhale. Send the hands down, step or float into high plank. Lower down to low plank. Up dog breath in, down dog breath out. Okay, let's have a little flow here now. Right foot goes up as you inhale. Step up to your warrior one. Square your hips and tuck your tailbone. Breathe in, rise up. Relax the shoulders as you breathe out. Another deep inhale, open out to warrior two as you exhale. So shuffle the feet, bring them in line. Extend out through those fingers. Good, flip the front palm, breath in, reverse your warrior. Lift through your right side. Lift through your left side. Another deep inhale. Extended side angle as you exhale. Rest on top of the knee or forearm goes parallel to shin. Big breath in. Send the hands down, come into high plank. Hold your high plank. Bring your feet together behind you and step your right hand into the center of the mat. Deep inhale, open out for a side plank as you exhale. So if you've got a little more in your side plank and you want to go for extended side plank, which B is demoing here, that's the right leg, sorry, left leg lifts up off the right. You can do this, okay? If you feel there's a little bit more in your pose than what we're asking you to do tonight, then just go for it. Another breath in, send the hands down to high plank. Continue the breath out to low plank. Up dog inhale, down dog exhale. Left foot goes up as you breathe in. Step up to warrior one. Reach up through the fingers, inhale. Square the hips, tuck the tailbone as you exhale. Another breath in, warrior two as you breathe out. Deep inhale, full exhale. Flip the front palm over, reverse the warrior. So again, lift up through the side of the body, but don't forget about your right side. We don't want to collapse into the right rib cage. So keep lifting that away from the hip. Deep inhale, extended side angle as you exhale. Good, breathe in, lift up. Exhale, open the chest sideways. Another breath in, send the hands down, step back into high plank, hold your high plank. The feet will come together, left hand will stack into the middle. Take an inhale. As you exhale, roll over onto the left side, opening out towards the right. Good. Lift up through those right fingers as you breathe in. Tuck the tailbone, draw the belly in as you breathe out. One more deep inhale. Send the hands down into high plank. As you exhale, go down into low plank. Up dog breath in, down dog breath out. Let's go again, a little bit faster this time. Inhale, right foot goes up. Warrior one. Reach for the ceiling, breath in. Warrior two. Flip the front palm, reverse. Exhale, extended side angle. Breath in. Send the hands down, high plank. Hold your high plank, bring the feet together, step the right hand in. As you exhale, open out to side plank. Deep inhale. Send the hands down, high plank. Low plank, up dog breath in, down dog breath out. Left foot goes up, inhale. Step up to that warrior one. Square the hips, tuck the tailbone. Warrior two. Flip the front palm, reverse the warrior, inhale. Exhale, extended side angle. Take a breath in, send the hands down. High plank, hold the high plank, feet together. Left hand steps into the middle, open out to side plank. Take a breath in, send the hands down as you breathe out, lower down to low plank. Up dog inhale, down dog exhale. We've got one more round to go. Send your right foot up, breath in. Step up, warrior one. Inhale, reach high. Exhale, warrior two. Flip the front palm, reverse. Take a breath in, exhale, extended side angle. Deep inhale, send the hands down. Step back to high plank. Feet together, right hand steps into the middle. As you exhale, open out for side plank. Breath in, send the hands down. High plank, low plank, up dog inhale, down dog exhale. Left foot, send it up. Big stretch up through that foot. Step up to warrior one. Reach for the ceiling. Warrior two. Flip the front palm, breathe in reverse. Exhale, extended side angle. Deep inhale. Send the hands down. Step into high plank. Feet together, left hand into the middle. Open out for side plank. Breath in. Send the hands down. High plank, low plank. Up dog inhale, down dog exhale. Take a big breath in. Open the mouth as you exhale. Deep inhale. Flutter the lips this time. Good. Nice. Breath in. Flutter or open the mouth, whatever you need to do. Remember, you've got lion's breath, you've got giraffe breath, zebra breath. They're all there, okay? Keep sending the chest backwards, hips up, heels down. Okay, take a big breath in. Step or float to the top of the mat as you breathe out. Take a rag doll. Good. So feet are going to go hip distance apart. Take hold of elbows. Ooh, take hold of elbows there. My voice went a bit funny. You can interlink the hands behind the back if you wish. Interlink fingers, should I say. You can use a strap here. Allow yourself to gently sway from side to side. Let's come back into that pose then. That's it. Good stuff. Remember, the wardrobe hopefully isn't going to fall over, so you haven't got to lean against it to hold it up. Okay, keep pushing down through the feet, up through the hips. You feel that opening, that lengthening up through the back of the legs. Okay, now keep the feet where they are. Let go of the elbows. Let go of the hands from behind you. Now, some of you probably may want to use a block here. I like to use the block. I have tight hamstrings or tightish. Other people just like to put the hand down onto the mat. So you're going to put a block if you need it underneath the left hand. Okay, choose the height that you wish it to be at. Take your peace fingers, wrap them around the big toes. The big toe on the right foot, should I say, the right big toe. Okay, now we're going to lift the right heel in towards the right glute muscle. Okay, so I'll show you from the side. You're going to lift the right heel in towards the right glute. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, you're going to send that leg out towards the side. Okay, now you can take the hand off and send that out towards the side of the room as well. Oh, you can keep the hand on the block on the ground if you wish, or you can send it out towards the side. Then if you can see B there, she's got a hand out towards the side. Good. Oh, nice there, Liam. It was a split second, but it was there. Good. So we can get that hand off the floor there, Beth, and I'm pretty sure you can. Pretty sure. Good stuff. Ah, yes. Fantastic. Keep holding. Stefania, how are we doing there? Let's get that foot back up off the ground. Yeah. Okay. Take a deep inhale and bring that foot back down to the ground as you exhale. Whew. Give the back of the left leg a little bit of a shake or a drum if you need to. Both legs if you wish. Feet are hip distance apart. Take the block. Place it underneath your right hand. You may not need to. Choose your height. Good. Now wrap the fingers around that big toe on the left foot. Good. Now breathe in as you lift that left heel towards the glute muscle. Good. Make sure you're balanced, okay? Make sure you're happy with how your pose is here. And on your next breath out, you're going to send that left foot out towards the side of the room. If you can, you're going to extend that left arm out. That's it. Yes. Nice, Zen. Fantastic. Relax the face at the same time. Good. Brilliant, Corey. See if you... Oh, that's it. I knew you could lift that leg up a little bit more. Yes. Good. That's it. See if we can straighten that leg out, Laura, towards the side of the room. That's it. Yeah. Keep holding. A few more breaths. Good. Take another deep in out. As you exhale, release out. Foot goes down. Oh. Give the back of the legs a little bit of a drum. We've got some drama going on in the mats in this room. Okay, bring the feet together. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, the hands down, step or float into high plank. Low plank, up dog breath in, down dog breath out. Take your deep inhale and your full exhale. Send your right foot up to the ceiling, breath in. Step up to crescent lunge as you breathe out. Good, so soften the back knee. So you're sitting into the hips quite a lot. You know, although my left leg is engaged, my knee is soft and it's almost, my hips are like a spring. You can kind of bounce up and down, send the hands up to the ceiling. Okay, now keeping that left arm reaching up nice and high. Take the right hand, place the hand down onto the sacrum area, okay? So the right hand will go down onto the sacrum. Inhale, lift through the left fingers. As you exhale, start to lean backwards, taking that nice little back bend. As you lean backwards, you're going to push the right hand down into the sacrum to help you tuck the tailbone underneath. And by tucking tailbone, we're going to get a nice little stretch through the left hip flexor. And as we do that, we draw the right foot back into the center to fire up the hamstring right side. Relax the neck and breathe. Good. Keep lifting through the chest. Take another deep inhale. As you exhale, start to come back up. Send the right arm up towards the ceiling. Breath in. Open out to, open out to warrior three as you breathe out. Suddenly went into warrior two there. Good. So both arms go up. All we do is flick off the back toes. Warrior three. Good. Now push down through the right foot. So you're pushing the ground away from you here. As you push the ground away, you're lifting that left leg up. So use your left glute muscle. It's a big muscle. Let's make it work, okay? So use it, engage it, lift up that left leg as high as you can. Try not to stack the hips. We want to keep the hips pretty square to the mat. Good. Deep breath in. Half moon as you breathe out. So now the right arm is going to go down, left arm is going to reach up. Brilliant. Now, rather than being in a half moon and thinking, hey, I've got to touch the ground, compromising your pose, keep the spine straight. So we've got our left leg straight all the way through the upper body. Three more breaths. Good. Take another deep inhale and release into ragdoll as you exhale. Place that foot downwards, feet hip distance apart. Take hold of the elbows and just allow yourself to hang forward. Whew, I've got a little bit of head rush there. Whew, breathing a bit too much. Okay, bring the feet together. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, the hands down, step or float into high plank. Lower down to low plank. Up dog, breath in. Down dog, breath out. Left foot goes up, inhale. Step up to crescent lunge as you exhale. Then we'll send those both arms up towards the ceiling. Tucking tailbone, lifting toes. Good, now right arm stays up this time. Left arm goes down behind you. Palm is flat on the sacrum area, okay? So that's the lower part of the spine. Just above the glute muscles. Good, take a deep inhale as you lift up through the front of the chest. As you exhale, start to reach backwards, pushing down through the left hand, so you're pushing the tailbone downwards. Softening through the right knee, but at the same time, keeping the right leg engaged. So rather than pushing backwards through the heel with a straight leg, allow the knee to bend. Good, deep inhale into the front of the body. Exhale. If it's comfortable, relax the neck, okay? Allow the head to hang backwards. If it's not, keep chin to chest. Keep chin to chest. Good. Just two more breaths. Good. Another deep inhale. As you exhale, release out. Send that left arm up towards the ceiling. Take a breath in. Flick off the back foot. Come up into warrior three as you breathe out. Good. So it's just one nice little movement. We inhale, we flick off those toes, and we lift up as we exhale. Good. Now have a tiny, tiny little bend in that right, in that left knee. That tiny little bend will activate a lot more of the muscle through the whole of the leg, which will help you balance a lot more, okay? You know, we've got to switch on all those juicy little muscles in the leg. We've got to make them think. We've got to make them work to help us balance. Take your deep inhale. Half moon as you exhale. Left arm goes down, right arm goes up. That's it. And if you're thinking right now, I just want to go into my Shavasana, then focus on your breath. Keep opening that chest sideways. Right hip is stacking on top of left. Right leg is pushing backwards, so you've got it straight. Good, I can see a few people using props there. Nice, that's why we have them, brilliant. Good, take a deep inhale. As you exhale, release out into your ragdoll. Good, feet go hip distance apart. Drum the back of the legs if you need to. Good, we haven't finished yet though, okay? Good, do I have a towel? No, I don't have a towel. Somebody keeps taking. Don't need towels. Yeah, I keep getting told I don't need a towel lately. Don't need a towel? Sweat it out, boy. Okay. Now bring the feet together. Now, you may want to use blocks here. I love to use blocks in this next one. So you may want to stand them up nice and tall, lay them down flat, or even the hands can go on the ground. Feet together. Fold over the front of those thighs. Take an inhale into your shoulder blades. As you exhale, standing split. Left leg is going to go up towards the ceiling. Start with the blocks tall. Make them go low or mid-low and then go even lower. Or maybe you don't even want to start with blocks at all. Good, now breathe into the shoulder blades. Breathe into the back of your right leg. Good, now with your right hand, you're gonna reach backwards and take hold. So bend your left knee, take hold of your right ankle. Just gave me a good idea there, actually, I like that. You're gonna take the left ankle. The right hand is going to go onto left ankle, staying in your foot in your standing splits. Okay, now take a deep inhale. Slowly start to rise up as you exhale. Good, about halfway in, you want to start to breathe in as you send that left arm up towards the ceiling, coming into twisted dancer. Whew. Oh, there we go, yeah. You can blame B for this one. I suddenly sort of thought, that's a good idea. Yeah, that's a good idea. I like that. Okay, now fit foot. Left foot stays flexed, okay? So keep the foot flexed. You gotta kick backwards, the same as we do in an ordinary dancer, okay? Kick the foot backwards, open the chest forwards. Reach up through the fingertips. Take another deep inhale. Let's start to fold forwards as we exhale, coming back into those standing splits. Okay, draw that left heel into the glute muscle and then let go of the heel or let go of the ankle. Right hand goes down, left leg goes up. Take a big breath in and release as you breathe out. Left foot goes down. Give that right leg a little shake, little tap up through the back of the leg. Okay, we're going to do it all again on the other side. Okay, so get focused, get breathing. Okay, feet come together, hands on the ground, hands on your blocks. I don't care where they are, as long as you're sturdy. Okay, take a deep inhale into the shoulder blades. As you exhale, send that right leg up towards the ceiling. Bending the knee if you need it. Nose close to the knee. You can have a micro bend anyway. Remember that micro bend, it will switch on all of those tiny little juicy muscles that run down through the leg. Good, allow the spine to be long, head to be heavy. As you breathe in, you can feel your shoulder blades, you can feel your upper back space expanding. Okay, now bend your right leg. So draw the right heel in towards the glute. Now reach backwards with the left hand. Take hold of the ankle. Good, take an inhale. And an exhale. Breathe in as you start to rise up. Nice and slowly. Nice and slowly reaching up. Control that movement. That's it. Good. Open the chest forward. Start to kick backwards. Twisted dancer here. Reach up through the right arm. Good. As you reach up and you kick backwards, I want you to push the right hip down towards the ground. So we're still squaring the hips. We're not opening completely to the side of the room, although we're in a little twist here. We're keeping those hips squared off. Good. Big breath in. And now start to fold forwards as you breathe out. Draw the right heel in towards the glutes. Good, now let go, place the left hand down if you need to. Send that right foot back up for standing splits. Good, breath in. And release as you breathe out. Whew. Give the back of the legs a little drum, shake it out to the side. Oh. Okay. Bring the feet together, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise and shine all the way up. Big stretch up. Palms to the center of the chest as you breathe out. Okay, now we're gonna go for our standing big toe grab. Now, there's a few ways you can do this. Option one is you can go straight in. You can lift up, take hold of the big toe, take your breath in. As you exhale, you're gonna send it out towards the front of the room. You'll inhale, and then exhale, you're gonna send it out towards the sides. If that's not quite there for you, just take hold of the knee, okay? Hold onto the knee, lift up, exhale, send it out to the sides. But if you've got a strap nice and handy, you can use a strap, okay? Use a strap. You're gonna lift up, exhale, send that foot out, take another breath in, and then as you breathe out, you'll send that leg out towards the sides. Good, three options there. Work with whatever one suits your practice tonight. Good. Now, as you stand here and hold, I want you to breathe and lift up through the spine. So from the foot on the ground to the crown of the head, you're lifting, you're stretching. And then as you breathe out, you're pushing out through the right foot and out through the left fingers. Good. I hope you're not using the wall there, Ursula. No, I'm not, she says. Okay, take a deep inhale. Bring that foot back in as you exhale. Another breath in and release as you breathe out. Let's go for the other side now. So lift up that left foot. Good, leg is engaged. Take hold of the toes. Stand tall, breath in. Use a strap or just take hold of the knee. As you breathe out, start to send the foot forwards. Right arm can go out to the edge. Take a deep inhale. Send that left leg out. Good, use a strap. Lift it up nice and high. If you're like me, you know, you might need to bend your knee even if it's going out to the side. I hope you're not resting your foot on the kitchen cabinets there, Pavel. No, good stuff. No. That's it. Focus on breath. Focus on lift. Take one more inhale. As you exhale, release out. Good. Place the foot down onto the ground. Bring the palms together at the center of the chest. Take a breath in. And a breath out. Inhale, send those hands nice and high. Left arm stays up, right arm reaches backwards, dancer's pose. Good, start with the knees together. Let right foot, so rather than taking the hold of the foot, take hold of the ankle. Now breath in into the front of the body as you reach up. As you exhale, start to kick backwards. Kick backwards, then reach forwards. push down through the right hip. So we'll have a tendency to start to lift that right hip upwards, away from the mat, away from the ground. I want you to push it down. Okay, one more breath in. As you exhale, release out. Foot goes down, palms come together. Fill up. Empty out. Inhale, send the hands nice and high. Right arm stays reaching up, left arm cartwheels backwards, taking hold of the ankle. Left foot is flexed, the toes are curling. Knees start together, breath in. Breath out, you're gonna kick backwards, reach forwards. Good, so always start the kicking backwards before you reach forwards. Good, tuck the tailbone. Good, I wanna see if you can kick that foot a little bit further back there, Claire. Emma, that's it, lift that knee, that's it, yes, good. Keep lifting that left knee up, brilliant stuff. The more you lift that knee, the more you kick backwards, you should start to feel it in the quad, in the front of the thigh. Take another deep inhale. As you exhale, release out. Foot goes down, palms come together. Breath in, breath out. Inhale, send those hands up. Exhale, bow forwards. Flat back inhale. Send the hands down, step or float into high plank. Lower down to low. Up dog breath in, down dog breath out. Bring the feet together, take a breath in. Step, jump or float to the top of the mat. Come to lay down on your back. Whew, there we go. So we're gonna lay down on the back. You can hug the knees in, you can take a full body stretch. Good, you can move your camera if you need to move your camera, or your screen, sorry. Good, now let me move my microphone before I sit on it. Okay, so, do you know what? I haven't done one of these for a while, actually. Is everybody gonna... Hopefully, everybody's got blocks or something that they're using in place of blocks. So if you have, take one block, place it in between your ankles, so just above your ankles. If you've only got one block, just use one block, okay? If you've got no blocks, stick a cushion, okay? Stick a, what do you think you're doing? Stick a cushion in between your, in between the ankles, okay? In fact, I'll get a cushion just to demonstrate. You can get a cushion or a book, anything. Anything that you've got, you can kind of clamp onto, okay? The what? Encyclopedia? Oh, yeah, or an encyclopedia, B says. Yeah, it might be a bit heavy, that one. Okay, you can put that in there. Right, so we want it in there, and now we're going to come down onto forearms. Come down onto the beach pose. We can't go to the beach at the moment, but we can at least pretend, all right? Okay, so switch on the legs, curl the toes backwards, inhale, lift the feet up off the ground. Good, now hold, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lower those feet down. Take a breath in, take a breath out. Inhale, lift those feet up. Hold, 5, 4, 3, 2, one, lower down. Deep inhale, full exhale. Let's go again, breath in. This time we lift up, we send the arms forwards. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Forearms down, feet down. Breath in, breath out. Inhale, lift the feet, send the arms forwards. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Send everything down. Breath in, breath out. Lift those feet, send the arms forwards. Good, keep going. For 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax down. Good stuff, everyone, brilliant. Okay, take a full body stretch. Send the hands backwards, feet go forwards. Drop the abs if you want to. Got a foot there, oh, got a foot behind me. Okay, now draw the knees into the chest. Breath in. What have we got here? Oh, we've got time for one more. Okay, shins are going to come parallel to the ground. Hands are going to go behind the head, interlink the fingers. Okay, take a deep inhale. So lift the head and the shoulders off the mat. So you're looking through the space in between your thighs, okay? Now keep the feet hip distance apart. Take an inhale. Send those feet forwards as you exhale. Take a breath in. Draw the knees back in as you breathe out. Inhale, send them forwards. Exhale, draw them in. Eight more, breath in forwards. Exhale, draw them in. Make sure the feet don't touch the ground. Head and shoulders up. Send them forwards. Draw them in. Slow it down, okay? Not too fast. Send them forwards. Draw them in. And again, forwards, draw them in. I think we've got five more left to do. Inhale, send them forwards. Exhale, draw them in. Make sure we're not touching the ground, anybody. Inhale, send them forwards. Breath out, draw them in. Inhale, send them forwards. Exhale, draw them in. I'm making sure these two aren't cheating. Inhale, send them forwards. Good stuff. Exhale, draw them in. What's that? Seven more left to do? Exhale, draw them in. Take a deep inhale and release as you exhale. Good. Drum the abs if you need to. Take a full body stretch. Hug the knees in. Happy baby pose. Any one of those. Okay, let me get rid of my cushion. Okay, hug the knees into the chest. Start to rock backwards as you breathe out, forwards as you breathe in. We know what's coming here, so build the momentum up. You have options as well, but we are going to go for a shoulder stand. But if you've got that headstand, handstand, forearm stand, you're more than welcome to take it. Next roll back, you're going to send the feet up. Hands come to the lower spine. Draw the legs together so you can see the legs switch on, okay? You can see that engagement in muscles, quads. They're calf muscles. You okay now? Good, that's it. Brilliant stuff. Oh, I can see a couple of headstanders there. Fantastic, I like it. Good, shoulder standers, brilliant. Nice there, Corey. Control that lifting. Make sure both legs are engaged as you go upwards. Core is engaged. Good, nice breathing, fantastic, brilliant now. How are we doing there, Jamie? I think you might have frozen. Good, shoulder standers, push up through those feet. Draw the elbows and shoulder blades together behind you. Good, nice. Okay, take a deep inhale. Shoulder standers, come down into plow pose as you exhale. Head standers, child's pose is there if you want to, when you want to come down into it, okay? Good. Shoulder standers, make sure you're breathing. You're not holding the breath. You want to breathe as much as you can, okay? It's restrictive, yes, but breathe. Good, Corey, make sure you're still pushing down for those forearms. So we've got minimal contact with head and ground there. Good, shoulder standers, take an inhale. Start to lower down to the mat as you exhale. So bring the hips down to the mat. That's half a breath out. Keep the legs straight and then lower the heels down for the rest of the breath, okay? That's it, good, fantastic. Okay, fish on a brick time now. So take your brick, take your bricks, your books, your whatever it is. Maybe you've gone and got a house brick and wrapped it in a towel, you're using that. Place it down in between the shoulder blades. As you breathe out, lay down onto it. Allow shoulders. I just want to open, opening chest to the side. Opening the throat, the neck. Like I say, this is a great pose because we spend a lot of time, and you know, I've said this so many times, you've heard this so many times, we spend so many hours in our day kind of hunched over computers, phones, TVs, laptops, tablets, whatever it is, books, magazines. So this is just nice to kind of do this pose once or twice a day. Where you can allow the inner part of the body. So this is the inner part of the spine, that faces into the body. Same with the neck. You can allow the throat to open, stretch. breathing as you're here, breathing into the front of the body, opening that chest up towards the ceiling. If you're in butterfly pose with the legs, allow the knees to be heavy so they open up the inside of the thighs up into the groin. Take a deep inhale. Release as you exhale, so roll over to your right side. Come to lay down flat on your back. We'll take a supine twist. So we'll draw the right knee into the chest, sending it over to the left side as we breathe in. Right arm reaches up to the corner of the room, corner of your mat. Breathe into the right side of the body. Bring that right knee back into the center, sending the foot forwards. Bring left knee into the chest. Send it over to the right side as you extend out through that left arm. Bring that left knee back into the center, sending it towards the front of the mat. Come into Ashtabhasana with legs, arms beside us, palms facing up. Take a deep inhale through the nose. Open the mouth, exhale. Again, breath in. Open, exhale. Let the breath go, eyes close, body relax. Breath is shallow. Not a deep breath, not a long breath. It's just that shallow, everyday breathing. Thank you. yourself back into your Shavasana if you've wandered off somewhere. Now start to deepen your breath. Bring movement to the fingers, to the toes. Allow the head to roll from side to side. Bring the head back into the center as you breathe in. Draw the knees into the chest as you breathe out. Inhale. Roll over to the right as you exhale. Take a breath in. Come into your seated position as you breathe out. Legs crossed, eyes closed, palms together at the center of the chair. We'll close our practice tonight with three ohms. Take a deep inhale. Thumb knuckles to our third eye center, and together we say namaste. Namaste, everybody. Well done. Round of applause. Woo! So thank you again for allowing us to be part of your practice, for inviting us into your home.